Recently, a Texas oilman suddenly found himself facing a frightening fate.
While Bud Brigham was working at his offices here in the Austin area, little did he know that the death of two birds hundreds of miles away in North Dakota could threaten to put him in a prison cell.
His drill sites, like most, have waste pools next to them, and some birds land in them and drown. Brigham got word a federal prosecutor was making a special effort to find such dead birds.
A Justice Department appointee apparently chartered a helicopter to go search for this and flew around to all the different well sites in western North Dakota.
This prosecutor used what he found to charge seven oil and gas companies with criminally killing birds, two mallards in Brigham's case, in violation of the Migratory Bird Treaty Act. Now, this 1918 law was only supposed to be used on poachers or hunters deliberately and illegally killing migratory birds. But that didn't stop this prosecutorial team.
They had found 28 total birds and two on our well sites. And for two mallards, there were cash fines, but also that as CEO that I could potentially serve two consecutive six-month terms in prison.
Vigrant Reddy fights for criminal and prison reform from a think tank in Texas.
It just seems completely absurd to think that you would lock somebody up for something like that.
I am a father of five, with children from 8 to 17 years old, and to think that I could possibly go to prison for this for up to a year, it was just really, really almost, it was very surreal.
Even more surreal, if the government could have imprisoned these oil execs, it could theoretically throw any American in jail if they had any connection to a migrating bird's death. So the judge ruled he couldn't go along with what the prosecutor wanted because it would yield absurd results, like criminalizing farming, cutting brush and trees, driving, owning a building with windows, owning a cat, all of which end up killing birds. The government wanted to punish the oil execs for 27 bird deaths. But Judge Hovland pointed out power lines kill as many as 174 million, cats, hundreds of millions, crashing into windows, 97 to 976 million a year, crashing into cars, maybe 60 million. So the judge wrote, to be consistent, the government would have to criminalize driving, construction, airplane flights, farming.
Every company that has power lines, every person with a home that the duck accidentally flies into, they would be criminally culpable.
So the judge tossed out the case. But you have to wonder why the government would go after these oil execs and not their fellow energy producers in the wind industry, which kills 33,000 to 250,000 birds a year with its wind turbines. Maybe this wasn't about the birds, but harassing an industry not green enough for the Obama administration.
There's been some criticism that perhaps the presidential administration isn't as enthusiastic about all the drilling as the drillers themselves and the people of North Dakota, frankly.
It does seem that there's hostility towards us. There was an EPA administrator here in North Texas that talked about crucifying the oil and gas industry to set an example.
Paul Rosenzweig co-authored the book One Nation Under Arrest.
Just as individuals can be subject to arbitrary and capricious prosecution, so too companies can be. Often they are disfavored companies who make products that somebody in authority thinks shouldn't be made, even though they're perfectly legal.
And with so many laws on the books these days, and more being added all the time, the government can find a way to prosecute almost any citizen or industry it wants.
On average, every American probably commits about three felonies a day.
Brigham says it feels un-American the way the feds have targeted him and tried to put him away.
We're being attacked by our own government, and it is startling and it's frightening.
Meanwhile, a favorite industry like wind gets away with literally littering the landscape with bird corpses. Some in government are even proposing this.
To give wind turbines the freedom to kill the bald eagle, the national bird. And here they go after us for a couple of mallards.
So here's maybe a matter of both over-criminalization and under-criminalization. Executives with the unfavored oil companies threatened with jail time for killing a couple of dozen birds, while those who build wind turbines, the darling of clean energy advocates, well, they kill tens of thousands of birds a year and never hear a word from the Justice Department. Paul Strand, CBN News, reporting from Austin, Texas.